An investigation into the deaths of eight people at a music concert in Texas has taken a sinister turn. Police are looking into reports that a security guard was injected with a drug before falling unconscious.
In amongst a mass of music fans, a tragedy is unfolding. Dozens are injured and some are dying, crushed in a crowd surge.
It was kind of mind-blowing. Like, we kept hearing people say, stop the show, but we didn't know what was going on.
They were like chanting like stop the show, and there was a guy in the back like getting like CPR.
It was like you were suffocating in there. Like you weren't like on the side or anything, you were getting suffocated.
Trying to help, an emergency vehicle crawls through the crowd. Oblivious fans swarm the first responders, even dancing on the vehicle's roof. Those who realise something is wrong try to stop the concert, pleading with a cameraman to raise the alarm. On stage, confusion. Rapper Travis Scott is silenced mid-set, realising something is wrong.
We need somebody to help him. Somebody passed out right here. Somebody passed out right here. Hold on, don't touch him, don't touch him. Everybody just back up.
In the chaos, eight people died, including a 14 and 16-year-old, but police are yet to confirm the cause of death, and today the investigation took a sinister turn.
One of the narratives was that some individual was injecting other people with drugs.
A security guard says that during the concert, he felt an injection in his neck before falling unconscious. He was revived by medics using Narcan, a type of rescue jab designed to combat the effects of a drug overdose.
Medics used Narcan jabs several times during the concert.
In the 30 years that major, for example, events have taken place in the city, whether they were on city facilities or county facilities, we've never had anything like this occur.
Astroworld was an event organised by Live Nation. 50,000 people attended. The venue legally fits four times that. Today, it's empty. The two-day show cut short, along with the lives of eight young music fans. In the United States, Michael Genovese, 9 News.